Thank you. Day ceremony in Wreathling. We're going to start off with Sweeney Post 2 posting the colors. Would everyone please rise? Present her. Order arms. And I'd like to have Bill Moore come up and do the benediction.
Dear Lord, today we honor our veterans, worthy men and women, who gave their best when they were called upon to serve and protect our country. We pray that you will bless them, Lord, for their unselfish service in the continual struggle to preserve our freedom, our safety, and our country's heritage for all of us. Bless them abundantly for the hardships they faced, for the sacrifices they made, and for the many different contributions to America's victory over tyranny and oppression. We respect them, we thank them, we honor them. We are proud of them, and we pray that you will watch over them, these special people, and bless them with peace and happiness. In the Heavenly Father's name we pray. Amen.
At this time, I'd like to call up the district director from District 4 in New Hampshire. The auxiliary is going to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Thank you. Everybody can be seated, get comfortable. Welcome to the 2022 Veterans Day ceremony in Wreathling. Isn't this great weather compared to last year? And I think you're probably as relieved as I am not to hear any more political ads on the radio and television. Today is a day to honor all men and women who served in the U.S. military. It's about approximately 19 million U.S. veterans who are still with us today, and millions who have preceded them since the American Revolution. Many serve in their communities as first responders, teachers, healthcare workers, and church leaders. Some are business owners, farmers, company workers, and retirees. Veterans are a diverse group, represented by men and women of every economic, ethnic, religious, and political background. They come from every state and territory, but are bound by one common commitment: to defend America with their life if called upon. From fighting terrorism, defeating fascism, and liberating slaves, veterans have a record of remarkable accomplishment throughout our nation's history. For many veterans, this nation was worth enduring long separations from their families, missing the births of children, freezing at sub-zero temperatures, sweating in the deserts of the Sahara and other deserts, sacrificing their health, and far too often losing their lives. When a political laments the cost of a veterans program, it is up to us to remind them of the cost of being a veteran. Whether it's exposure to burn pits or other toxins, many veterans today continue to pay the high price for their military service. It is up to us to ensure that they always have access to high quality health care and benefits, reflecting the thanks of our great nation. It is fitting that Veterans Day we observe so close to Election Day. It is, after all, the veterans who have preserved our constitutional rights for 246 years. Just think, 4 years will be our 250th birthday. It's my honor now to introduce the guests that we have. On my right is Verna Bellavo, the director of District 4. The Manchester Veterans Council Chaplain, Bill Morin. Former Alderman at Large, Mike Lopez. We have Dave Quinn, the Department, the State of New Hampshire Finance Officer for the American Legion. We have Wayne Parra, the Adjutant for the American Legion, State of New Hampshire. We have our Grand Marshal this year, Peggy LeBrec. And last but not least, without whose support and the support of the Manchester departments, especially the fire, police, and parks, we would not be able to conduct these parades and ceremonies. I'd like to introduce our mayor, Joyce Craig.
Well, good morning. I want to start by thanking Dan Bellavo, Bill Morin, and Alderman Mike Lopez, and everyone at the Manchester Veterans Council for organizing today's events. And many thanks to Peggy LeBrec as well for serving as today's Grand Marshal. It's wonderful to have you here. And I also want to recognize the Central Marching Band. It's wonderful to have you here representing the high schools in the city of Manchester. It's a privilege to be here with all of you as we honor our service members and remember the sacrifices that they made and the courage it takes to defend honor, duty, and country. I'm standing before you as mayor of the city of Manchester, but it's important to note that I've never enlisted or worn a military uniform or gone to war. I've never had to leave my family for months or years to defend my country, and I've never experienced what you, our service members, have: the fear, the bravery, the suffering, and their survival associated with putting your lives on the line for our freedom. But today and every day, I'm a grateful American. A grateful American who has the honor of representing our wonderful community in thanking our heroes on Veterans Day. Veterans serve not to seek fame and glory. Our veterans serve to fulfill an inner calling and a sense of personal responsibility. Our service members are answering the call to defend and protect the people and the country we all love. So today, we honor our service members for the sacrifices they've made so we can live in freedom. To all the men and women in uniform, thank you for your dedication and commitment to our country. I also want to express my heartfelt thanks to the families of our service members who experience the challenges and stresses that come along with military life. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor.
Let's see.
Senator Jean Shaheen served since 2009. Previous to that, she was governor of New Hampshire, 1997 to 2003. She's not able to be here with us, but has provided a letter, which I will read at this time. Dear veterans and friends, thank you for the invitation to be with you today in Manchester as you come together to honor our nation's veterans. Please know that I join you in spirit as we salute the men and women who have fought across generations to safeguard a way of life and protect our country in a dangerous world. We gather today just over 100 years after the formal end to fighting in a devastating conflict in Europe. World War I was known at the time as the Great War, and in the war to end all wars. And its end gave cause to celebrate the heroics of men and women who served in those distant trenches. In that war, and in the century that followed, we called upon our brave soldiers, sailors, airmen, and Marines to defend our country and its highest ideals. Time and time again, they answered. They made, as the World War II Memorial in Washington, D.C. states, the sacrifices to perpetuate the gift of our forefathers entrusted to us, a nation conceived in liberty and justice. We pause each year on the anniversary of the end of the Great War to honor the dedication, perseverance, courage, and loyalty of the American veterans. Veterans Day is not only a chance to recognize them for their devotion to duty and their service in uniform, it is also an opportunity to reflect on our duty as fellow citizens, to show appreciation, and to provide them with the care and benefits they so rightly deserve in civilian life. I've had the privilege of meeting many veterans and their families in my travels across New Hampshire and the world. As governor and U.S. senator, their strength, their goodwill, and their humility is always a source of inspiration for me during difficult times. America's veterans have given a great gift to our nation, and many continue to contribute to the good of their communities long after their time in the service. I'm proud to join you today in expressing our deep gratitude to these courageous and selfless men and women. Sincerely, Jean Shaheen, United States Senator. Senator Hassan served as New Hampshire governor from 2013 to 2017, and then elected to the U.S. Senate in 2016. She's not able to be here with us, but has provided a letter which I will read. Dear friends, I regret that I cannot be with you for today's parade, but I join you in honoring all of our country's veterans, service members, and their families for their selfless and patriotic service. Every year we come together on Veterans Day to honor the courage, sacrifice, and devotion to duty of the men and women who have served in order to keep all of us safe, secure, and free. We also remember and express profound gratitude for our fallen heroes who made the ultimate sacrifice in service to their fellow citizens. I know we are all thinking of their loved ones today. I want to thank all of the dedicated service members, veterans, and your families here today for all that you have done to make our country safer and our freedom stronger. Your bravery and courage has helped ensure that we remain the strongest humanitarian and military force in the world. On Veterans Day and every day, it is essential to reflect on and recommit to the values for which you have fought so valiantly. Thank you to the Manchester Veterans Council for organizing today's parade. And once again, thank you to all the veterans gathered here today. We owe it to you, to all you, all who serve or have served, to continue to work to make sure that our state and our nation is ever worthy of your sacrifice. With every good wish, Margaret Wood Hassan, United States Governor. Margaret Peggy LeBrec, MBA, NHA, lives in Northfield, New Hampshire with her husband, Armin. She worked for the state of New Hampshire since 1998, transferred to the New Hampshire Veterans Home in 2005, promoted to Commandant of the New Hampshire Veterans Home in 2013, retired from state service on March 4th, 2022. She is very proud of her service in the state of New Hampshire to our veterans and their families. She belongs to many organizations, including the VFW Auxiliary, the American Legion Auxiliary. Her eligibility is through her brother Jerry's service in Vietnam. The American College of Healthcare Administrators, supervisor of the checklist for the town of Northfield, since 2006. I'd like to introduce Peggy LeBrec.
Good morning. It is truly a pleasure to be here today. First, I'd like to say thank you to all our distinguished guests, especially our veterans who are here with us today. New Hampshire is certainly a better place because our veterans, when they came home from active service, they continue to serve in their local communities, their cities, their towns, and their state. I truly know this, having served or and been at the New Hampshire Veterans Home for 16 years and had the privilege and the honor of talking and visiting with many of our veterans. And some of the things that they would tell me is how much they enjoyed being in the American Legion with their comrades and their brothers at arms, being in the DAV and the VFW. They couldn't say enough about how important that was to them, that when they came home, they had that camaraderie. And I will tell you that I know today the veterans that are here are there serving. And whether it's peer-to-peer support for our veterans who are suffering from different ailments, or just being there to have a conversation and a cup of coffee. So I thank you very much for coming home and living the motto, service above self, because we know that that's what our veterans are and do every single day. So again, thank you very much for your service. God bless New Hampshire and God bless the United States. Thank you.
Thank you, Peggy. At this time, we're going to do the wreath laying, where the Grand Marshal, Peggy, and the Mayor will place the wreath in front of the bell over in the back of the field. There'll be a firing of volleys by the honor guard from Sweeney Post. So if you have any young children, get them ready or cover their ears. After the firing, we'll be playing of taps and an echo, and then the national anthem.
Thank you. present Hunt. Thank everyone once again for turning out for the ceremony. Special thanks to the Manchester Police Department, Fire Department, Parks and Recreation, Central High School Band. You guys did a fine job. The Color Guard from American Legion Post 2, and the firing detail. And while today we rejoice and honor the service of America's veterans, we also remember the wise words of General Douglas MacArthur. Quote, "The soldier, above all other people, prays for peace," end quote. I would have to add sailors, airmen, and Marines to that. God bless all of you for being here. God bless our veterans, and God bless America. Order permits. Thank you very much.